Hi, my name is Amit Jain. I'm an orthopedic spine surgeon. I see patients both at the Johns Hopkins Hospital as well as the Howard County General Hospital. I take care of both adults and children across the whole spectrum of spine disorders. Spinal stenosis is a process by which the nerves in the spine get pinched as a result of development of arthritis. The good thing is that with modern advances in technology as well as modern techniques, stenosis surgery has excellent outcomes, and patients really do very well. They make excellent recovery and get back to their life very quickly. Most people with stenosis experience some level of back pain, some level of leg pain. Patients might describe that they're having buttock pain that's shooting down the legs. They might have trouble walking around the grocery store, might need to use a buggy or a cart. Patients describe a variety of constellation of things that ultimately slow them down from their daily life. Spinal stenosis diagnosis requires obtaining an MRI or a CAT scan. MRI is something that your primary care doctor can order or something that we can order once you consult for the surgeon. The treatment of spinal stenosis really depends on the severity of the problem. Patients with mild stenosis or patients with early arthritis may benefit from physical therapy. They may benefit from epidural injections. Patients with more advanced stenosis, for them, surgery is the mainstay of treatment. The good thing is that surgery generally has excellent outcomes for this problem. Surgery may be indicated for spinal stenosis if patients have advanced arthritis leading to pinching of the nerves. Surgery may also be indicated if there is instability of the spine, which may result into further nerve damage. The surgery for spinal stenosis requires decompressing the nerves, which requires cutting out the bone spurs that are causing pressure on the nerves. Now, this can be accomplished in a variety of methods. Depends on the extent of the pathology, depends on how extensive the problem is, and based on that, we can use minimally invasive techniques or open techniques to address the stenosis. I was trained in orthopedic and neurosurgical techniques that allow us to safely decompress the nerves and safely take care of the problem without putting patients at additional risk. Patients generally see a fairly immediate relief of their symptoms after surgery for spinal stenosis. A lot of patients would wake up immediately after surgery and say how their leg pain is totally gone. Patients are able to get up and walk the same day. In a lot of cases, go home the same day. In some cases, we keep them overnight and then they go home the next day. The prognosis for spinal stenosis surgery tends to be excellent. Most patients make excellent recovery and really do very well with this. For about 6 weeks, patients might feel like their energy level is low, but that generally tends to come back. Most patients don't require additional surgery once the primary problem is addressed. Physical therapy is an excellent modality that we utilize frequently both before and after surgery. It's really important that patients get physical therapy as the primary stay before embarking on spine surgery. Physical therapy has multiple advantages because it can help patients in terms of reduction of their pain, in terms of getting them up and mobile, as well as in kind of setting the expectations on what to expect after surgery. So this concept of prehab, I think, is very valuable. Even after surgery, all our patients see a physical therapist in the hospital, and we get the patients to work with a therapist when they're in the hospital, as well as sometimes after they get discharged from the hospital at home or in an outpatient setting. Patients in Howard County are really fortunate because now there is this really wonderful new center, the Johns Hopkins Musculoskeletal Center, which is a collaboration between all these various providers, between the surgeons like myself who are trained in doing spine surgery, between physiatry medicine and rehabilitation providers who are experts in pain management, who are experts in injections, between our anesthesia providers and chronic pain providers who are experts in injections and pain management, as well as of our physical therapists, who are really kind of the mainstay of our rehab. So it's really a great collaboration, and we're really excited about this.